Hello students, welcome to our next video that is on the steering and suspension system for the two-wheelers. Right, until now we have almost seen all the things about the steering system and the suspension system as well. The things that are remaining is the types of the suspension system for the front side and for the rear side of the two-wheelers. There are different types of the suspension systems are being used in the case of the front side of the two-wheelers and the rear side of the two-wheelers. Also, we will see about the suspension system that provides the active suspension system in the new end of bikes or the sports bike type the system. So let's see about the types of the suspension system. We are remaining with the types of the suspension system. The first one is the single link type front suspension system. If you can see the figure clearly, is that it is almost similar system to the Wishbone suspension system that we used in the case of the four wheeler vehicles, right? If you can remember the suspension that we learned in the subject BAS, then you can remember that it is almost a similar type of suspension system that we use in case of the four-wheelers. It has one wishbone in the below part. On the wishbone, we have connected one suspension and steering linkages. The wishbone, or we can say the A-link, that has been provided on which our spring and shock absorber assembly has been arranged. So this is one simple example of the suspension system which is similar to the four-wheeler system, but as you can see that the linkages that we are providing is having an extra space, right? It is absorbing the space in the vehicle, and in the case of the two-wheelers, the space is an important factor, so we have to save the space. So it's better to use the previous versions that we saw in the earlier video. That was a telescopic suspension system, or the trailing and leading link suspension system was a better option compared to the single link type suspension system. The main advantage of the suspension system that you are saying is single link type is that it provides a better comfort compared to other types, because a proper linkages has been given, so the load transfer from the below of the wheel to the suspension system will be better, and the rigidity of the suspension system will also be better, so the suspension system absorbing capacity will be better compared to the previous types. The second type is the double link type front suspension system, in that the two links has been given to arrange the suspension system, one below the suspension and second above the suspension, which is similar to the double wishbone type suspension system that we saw in the four wheelers as well. Now the double link suspension system has the best comforting ability, right? But as you can see again, it has too many components, and it will also waste our space in the two wheelers, which is not available in all the two wheelers. These type of system can be used where comfort is the highest priority, right? In case of the normal two wheelers, we don't require these many components, otherwise the weight of this component will increase, and because of that the average of the vehicle will reduce. So we have to manage our components, and we has to use as low components, as few components as possible for the two wheelers. So in the case of the double link suspension system, you can see that two linkages has been provided, and in between that our spring and shock absorber assembly has arranged. Because of that, what we are doing is that the movement of the suspension system is being rigid, and it has been stiffened by the help of the two linkages. So movement will be up and down, the linkages will move with the suspension, and it will not be very rough movement. For example, the sideways movement will be stopped in case of the suspension, and whenever the suspension goes up and down, the linkages will go up and down with it, and the suspension ability will be absorbed by the help of this similar movement. Now let's see some type of the rear suspension system. Right, the suspension needs to be provided in the rear side of the vehicle as well, because the pylon will be sitting behind the driver in most of the cases for the two wheelers. So the pylon should have the comfort while driving as well. Otherwise, what will happen is that the front tire will go smoothly, but the rear tire will not go smoothly. So because of that, the pylon will not feel comfortable while sitting in the behind of the driver. So the first type that you are seeing is the hard tail rear suspension. Now the name suggests hard tail, right? It is a hard suspension system and it is not a soft type of suspension system. In the case of the hard tail suspension system, there is no shock absorber assembly or spring assembly attached in the rear side. One spring is attached below our seat, and that is the only suspension system that has been attached in this case. The two linkages provides an triangulation in the behind or in the rear part, and from that only the suspension given is below our seat. So this type of suspension will not be at all comfortable in case of the two wheelers. This type of suspension is generally used in a bicycle. Right, so this was an earlier approach for the suspension in the rear wheels. We have better modified version in case of the rear suspension. You can see the actual use of this hard-tail rear suspension that was used in the bicycle. The second type is the swing arm type rear suspension. Now the swing arm type suspension system is very widely used suspension system in case of the two wheelers, in case of the motorcycles as well. You can see in this figure that in the case of the rear, the suspension, which is the spring and shock absorber assembly, is attached with the swing arm, and one swing arm pivot is connected with our system. Right, so normally the swing arm is attached with our rear suspension. So whenever rear wheel goes up and down, our suspension system goes up and down. You might have seen this type of the suspension system in the motorcycle, which is very widely used. And the last type is the rocker and link type rear suspension system. In the case of the rocker and link type rear suspension system, one rocker and linkage is being first attached with itself. At that attachment, the suspension assembly, which is spring and shock absorber, is attached. Also, there is a swing arm which is attached in between those assembly, which is connected with our rear wheel, and the mounting which is connected with our frame. So this provides a better rigidity and better comfort to the driver because of the rocker arrangement and the link arrangement. The actual usage of the rocker link type suspension, rear suspension, you can see in this figure that from middle part the swing arm is going, and below you can see that rocker link has been provided on which our suspension system has been mounted. Next is the dynamic damping control, which is known as the DDC. This is an active system which we generally use in case of the suspension system, which works on the sensors. The sensors guides or gives the feedback about the condition, and according to that our suspension system actuates. The first thing is the ABS. Right, the ABS is connected with our DDC. Whenever we use an ABS, which is anti-lock braking system in case of the two wheelers, it will be indirectly connected to the DDC. The second thing is the semi-active suspension. Semi-active suspension, which means that some of the components is connected with our DDC and some of the components works manually. The next is the spring travel sensors. The spring travel sensors is also connected with our DDC. In the case of the spring travel, how much spring is moving with the vehicle driving. If the spring movement is more, then the actuation will be given to our damper by the help of the DDC. Also, the lean anchor sensor is connected, in which whenever vehicle takes turn, it will lean with the turn. As we have seen that it leans with the turn, mostly for the racing bikes, if you have seen that it has leaned. So that lean angle will be sensed by that. If that lean angle is more, then the signal will go to the DDC. and DDC will actuate the suspension, which will reduce the lean angle and which will keep the motorcycle up to a certain angle. ECU is provided, which is electronic control unit, which controls all these sensors and which provides the signal in the suspension system, however it should be working. And the last is the DDC control unit, which is connected with our ECU, which guides all the suspension system which is connected in our two-wheeler system. How the DDC is executed is, first the inputs from the ECU to DDC. The ECU takes the input from the system and it gives the input to the DDC. The second is input from the ABS to the DDC. The ABS also sends the signal to the DDC whenever we apply the brakes, so it controls the motion and controls the path of the vehicle. Next is the input from the lean angle sensor to the DDC. Whenever we take the turn, whichever lean angle is created, it will be sent to the DDC. And the last one is the inputs from the spring travel sensor to the DDC. Whatever the spring is traveling from up and down movement, that will be sent to the DDC. Let's see one brief video how the DDC works. This is the components of the DDC which is required for the two wheelers. Here you can see in the four wheelers the DDC has been employed. You can see the difference between the suspension for the actual and the DDC suspension system which was on the topper part. Here you can see the absorber that will be used for the DDC. In the case of the dynamic damping control, the active system works, so there will be number of sensors which will be connected with our system. You can see the all the components which are required for the dynamic damping control. These are the sensors which will be connected to our system, and the middle part is the DDC controller that you are seeing right now, that all things will be connected with our suspension. Now let's see the working. In the case of the working, the ECU and DDCU will be connected. During the starting, the marginal actuation in the valves in the front end gear will be provided so that normal damping will be getting. During the acceleration, stronger actuation of the valve in the rear suspension will be provided, because during acceleration the squat will happen, so vehicle will lift from the front side, so during the rear side the level will be maintained. This is a spring travel sensor which sends the signal to the DDCU, which controls the travel of the spring. Second is, during the cornering, what will happen is that the sensor or the IMU will be connected with our steering system, and whenever we take the turn with increase the inclination with the lean angle sensor, we will reduce the actuation in case of the front valve, and we will also strong the value calculation in relation to the rolling of the vehicle. Also we will reduce the valve actuation in the rear side when the vehicle goes straight. You can see the diagram of how the systems is attached. The DDC unit is connected ahead, the telescopic front fork. In the below part, the ABS sensor ring is connected. Also the ECU is connected in between the fuel tank, and in the below part we have connected the ABS module. So all the things are interconnected with our DDC systems. So this is how the system works, and this is how the DDCU system works. So in this video we saw about the components of the DDCU that is required to work in the dynamic damping control unit, and also we saw about all the systems, that is the type of the suspension. So this was it for this chapter. From the next lecture we will start a new chapter. Till then, thank you so much.